Hey, this is Erin popping back in with another response to a question about distance learning. So this question is around a seven-year-old. So question is, I've noticed some changes in my seven-year-old's behavior, and we often face these challenges when it comes to distance learning. She has a hard time working independently. She gets frustrated easily and refuses help. So I want us to just to think about a couple of things. One is in normal or typical times, right? The developmental task for a seven-year-old is they're straddling, what can I do and how well can I do it? And so even just in day-to-day experiences, they often can feel frustrated and overwhelmed because in their mind, they have this expectation of themselves or maybe an expectation that they've internalized from an adult that I should be able to do X, Y, or Z independently on my own. And then when the reality is I can't, I get frustrated and overwhelmed and I shut down or I get angry and frustrated and whatever that looks like for your kiddo. So I think just one, normalizing, like this is a typical developmental task and a typical developmental challenge. It's why we still continue to see emotional outbursts or emotional flooding, some temper tantrums, even in our elementary age kids. So a couple of suggestions for helping decrease potentially the setup for being overwhelmed and frustrated and not wanting help. One thing to think about is how overwhelmed, like for me, I have an 8-year-old, right? And when I open his Google Doc on Sunday evening to look at what the work for the week is, it's overwhelming to me. And so put yourself in the position of a 7-year-old opening that doc and seeing all of the work for all of your classes for the whole week. And it's no wonder they get overwhelmed and then feel frustrated because it feels like to them, it's so much, I'll never be able to do all of this. So a suggestion I would have is, actually, if they have a planner or you have a calendar at home that you can actually write down just day by day the work that they're going to do and then help them break it down. So you provide the external structure. This is what's going to happen throughout the week. Here are the times of day that we're going to work on schoolwork, and I will be here with you to support you if you have questions or if you need help answering something. But I'm going to let you do as much of it by yourself as you can. I'm going to sit right beside you. I'm going to be working on, you know, whatever it is that you're working on, work or reading a book, but I'm right here if that's what they need. If what they need is a little bit more space, cool. Work that out with them. You know, you're going to be working on schoolwork. I'm going to be working on X, Y, and Z. Here's how to get my attention if you need help. So it's that delicate balance of, I have a kid who struggles to work on this independently. So how can, you know, as the parent, you sit close enough to them to provide enough support, or I want to work independently, but I need to have easy access to an adult if I have questions. So that's a piece to think about. And then time, limit the amount of time that they're working on school per day. Focus on how much they can get done in a realistic chunk of time. In early elementary school, a couple hours, tops. Get done what you get done and move on. If at the end of the week, they still have work that's not done, send an email to the teacher. This is what we worked on. This is where we got this week. We'll continue to chip away at it. I hope that's helpful. Keep tuned for some more questions and answers.